ABBYY training in FlexiCapture continued. Let's talk about setting up a project with training. When you set up a project, it's pretty straightforward, creating a document definition, creating fields, and then doing some simple rubber banding so that the software can learn where the fields are. Such projects can be learned for a quick proof of concept or a quick demo, but depending on the complexity of the forms and the size of your sample set, it could be production ready. Or maybe you just need to open up the layout and make some adjustments for it to be production ready. So setting up a project with one variant, the first thing you need to do is create document definitions. And those document definitions need to have a section where the allow field extraction training option is selected. So let me point to that. So look for allow field extraction training. Then you create your necessary fields without region. And then you click on the general tab, can have region. Then you click view field extraction training batch to move to the field extraction training batch section and control N, create a new batch. And you'll be prompted to select the document definition that you want to train. And then you're going to just select the default variant because we only have one variant. Then we'll load images for that variant and we will correct the field location. We'll specify the field locations by rubber banding. And then we can right click on that training batch and an actual Flexi layout is created as a result of that training step. We can also set up a project with multiple variants. And there's another kind of mode we need to enter when we do that. So the first thing is we add our document definition with document sections with multiple variants. Then we open the classification training batch, click view classification training batch, right click new batch, then load images to that new batch. And then you're going to have to assign reference classes. So those will be drilling down into the document section variant level. So you're prompted to do this. There's a nice GUI interface that helps you do this. Then you train the classifier, and then FlexiCapture is able to classify these documents on a variant level. Then you're going to open up the field extraction training batch, and you're going to create a new batch for each variant. So you'll be prompted to select which document definition, and then which variant of that document definition with a document section with multiple variants. Select that variant, then you load images for that variant, and then correct the field locations, indicate the field locations, and train. So you'll end up with a separate training batch for each variant. So using a manual approach was the way we had to proceed in FlexiCapture 11 initially. We would have to create a layout, manually create elements in the header group and in the footer group, and create elements to get data from the body of the text. That was all manual work. And then in version 11, we came out with FlexiCapture for invoices with shipped. It shipped with a generic Flexi layout. That wasn't created by machine learning. It was created by our developers. That's why they're calling it manual development. To which you could add an additional layout, kind of an overarching layout that would grab data from all of your vendors, say for customer ID number, a field that FlexiCapture for invoices doesn't support. Then you could have some adjunctive layouts created automatically. So for a given vendor, if we're finding data in the wrong location, you rubber band the correct location, and these adjunctive layouts are spun up automatically. In version 12, we're depicting the addition of classification, where we use image, thumbnail, raster techniques to classify documents, as well as text rules, as well as rules, which are basically Flexi layout headers, combined to classify documents. And then moving over to FlexiCapture for invoices, we execute a generic Flexi layout, then any other additional layouts that you created. And then you can manually develop a layout for a given vendor, but then we also have vendor-specific layouts, adjunctive layouts that are created automatically on a vendor-by-vendor level based on corrections that your verification operator made. So when we are assembling documents, we can define classes as being for first page or any page. So when we encounter a first page, we're going to do separation. We can also classify whenever a footer is encountered. That's when we do separation. You can see how that's being separated. So if a Flexi layout has no obligatory footer, the next page is classified to define if the Flexi layout can still be applied. But if it has an obligatory footer, the Flexi layout is matched until it finds a footer. So we'll talk now about auto learning. This is where a verification operator performs actions. They're just basically doing their job. If a field is blank, they're going to specify where that data is. So this kind of action can be done either by administrators or by verification operators. What they're doing is providing that logic, that information that is needed to create layouts automatically. And in a production environment, FlexiCapture looks at training batches that are created automatically based on verification operators making positional changes. And once they think that all the sample documents, all the training data has been found, it will lock that training batch. And you can unlock it and add more images as an administrator or delete some images if needed. So the flow goes, images are ingested, they're recognized, maybe everything's perfect, the data goes directly to export. Or maybe there's a need for a verification and a verification operator specifies a new location, then usually after export, but possibly after verification, an auto learning step is launched where a training batch is created. And so the next document that comes in of that type, we should have better recognition. So we talked about machine learning training being applicable to standalone fields as well as tables and repeating groups. And we can use the classification training batches to detect variants. And then once we are in production, the software is watching verification operators' actions. And if they make a positional change, that's going to trigger a training event. That training event usually happens after the export workflow, but it also could happen right after verification. But that's a critically important capability so that your verification operator's actions help make the system smarter and work better.